Hello and welcome to TI Precision Labs. If you have designed or are considering designing a USB Type-C system, you have probably run into DisplayPort or DP alt mode. You might be wondering what is DP alt mode and how is it related to the USB Type-C system. This presentation gives you a quick overview of the DP alt mode. Before we begin, if you are not familiar with DisplayPort, please refer to the earlier TIPL video, What is DisplayPort, first. So what is USB-C and how is it different from the previous generation of USB connectors? First off, USB-C is a new connector and cable standard that is compatible with existing USB interfaces. A summary of USB Type-C features include a smaller form factor than the legacy connectors, connections and cables are reversible, giving a more user-friendly experience, supporting USB Type 4.0 and all previous versions of the USB standard, supporting scalable power charging, supporting alternate modes or alt mode, enabling different non-USB user cases, such as what we're going to cover today, the DisplayPort video, supports USB power delivery, PD, and has two SBU sideband buses that can be used. Some of the USB Type-C typical applications are USB 3 over Type-C, USB 2 only, USB 3 with DP alt mode, USB 3 with HDMI alt mode, USB 3 with customer alt mode, USB Type-C alt mode bi-directional redriver, and USB charging only port. Before going deeper into USB Type-C, it's important to go over some of the terminology that is associated with USB Type-C. USB Type-C defines a port to be either a downstream facing port, DFP, an upstream facing port, UFP, or a dual role port, or DRP. A DFP is the same as a host mode port. A UFP is the same as a device mode port. The DRP is a USB-C only feature, similar to the old USB 2.0 OTG. It indicates a mode in which both the host and the device are being supported. Now let's look at some of the possible configurations as an example. When a UFP is connected to a DRP, the DRP will configure itself into a DFP. Similarly, when a DFP is connected to a DRP, the DRP will configure into a UFP. When two DRPs are connected, one will be configured automatically or manually into a DFP, and the other will then be configured into a UFP. Please note that UFP to UFP or DFP to DFP connections are not supported and have no function. One thing to note is that in the legacy USB devices, the data and the power roll are the same and always connected with the USB host, or DFP. A USB host is always the data source and the power provider. However, with USB Type-C, the data and power roll are now separated. You can have a case in which a USB device is a data sink but a power provider, or you could have a USB host that is the data source but a power sink. Along with the separate power and data roll, USB Type-C also provides the ability to do separate data roll or power roll swapping. For example, a device may choose to keep its data sink roll, but switch from a power provider to a power sink. So, how is port configuration set up with USB Type-C? The USB Type-C port configuration is being achieved with the USB-C CC1 and CC2 pins. Functionally, the configuration channel, CC, is used to serve the following purposes in a sequential order. First, detecting the connection of a USB Type-C port. Second, resolving cable orientation and twist connections. Third, establishing DFP and UFP roles between the two connected ports. Fourth, discovering and configuring power in USB-C current modes or USB power delivery modes. And finally, discovery and configuration of optional alternate and accessory modes, which we'll be discussing later in this video. So how are CC1 and CC2 being controlled? They are both controlled by either a PD or a CC controller. The above table lists the feature differences between the PD controller and the CC controller. Depending on the required supported features of the USB-C design, either a PD controller or a CC controller will be used. For example, if video alt mode is required, then the PD controller has to be used because the CC controller does not support video alt mode. On the other end, if a video alt mode is not required and only 15 watts of charging is needed, then the CC controller will be the better choice for the USB Type-C design. One of the exciting new USB Type-C features is its ability for adaptive power delivery depending on the CC negotiation. The table above summarizes the progression of USB power delivery, starting at 500 milliamps with USB 2.0, then 900 milliamps with USB 3.1, and now with USB Type-C, we have 1.5 amps in medium current mode and 3 amps in high current mode. Using the CC pins, a DFP can advertise to its port partner, a UFP or a DRP, the amount of current it can supply. The CC negotiation allows the power source to manage the current it provides. An application of this management would be reducing the source current when battery life is low on a device. Besides the adaptive power delivery feature, USB Type-C also introduces alternate mode, or alt mode. The USB Type-C spec includes alt mode that enables the multi-purposing of designated pins in the Type-C receptacle for alternate uses. These alternate signals can be sent over the USB Type-C cable while offering the same electrical performance. The above block diagram shows the possible implementation of a DP alt mode. The four DisplayPort lanes are being repurposed to the USB-C high-speed signal lanes of TX1, TX2, and RX1 and RX2, while the aux signal is being repurposed to the open SBU channel. Since USB Type-C supports normal and flip cable orientations, an external configuration MUX is required to support this feature. A configuration MUX can either be a passive MUX without providing any signal compensation, or an active MUX, which integrates the passive MUX with a redriver or a retimer to provide high-speed signal compensation. Here you can see a simplified example of designing with a configuration MUX for USB only. The SSTX pin will be MUXed to the TX1, and the SSRX pin will be MUXed to RX1 for normal USB-C orientation. When the USB Type-C orientation is flipped, SSTX will then be MUXed to TX2, and SSRX will be MUXed to RX2. Here you can see a simplified example of designing with a configuration MUX for USB and DP alt mode only. For detailed DP alt mode implementation, please refer to the TIPL What is DisplayPort Alt Mode video. Here is a short quiz covering some of the fundamental topics I've covered in today's TIPL video. Please answer all four questions, and I'll cover the answers in the next slide. Here are the answers to the short quiz you have just taken. Question number one, DFP means device mode. This is false. UFP means device mode. Question number two, CC is needed to establish DFP and UFP roles between the two connected ports. This is true. Question number three, USB Type-C does not support normal and flip orientation. This is false. We covered this in depth in the previous three slides. Question number four, USB Type-C does not separate data and power roles. This is also false. Thank you for watching the TIPL video for USB Type-C basics and design considerations. Have a nice day.